Hallo und herzlich willkommen in der Kulturport Lounge bei Ape Jazz 2013 mit Lakeisha Benjamin. Welcome to Ape Jazz.
Hello, thanks.
You're a real New Yorker, right?
Yeah,
you're born and raised.
Born and raised in New York, Washington Heights.
That's very rare, isn't it?
It's rare in the music business. A lot of people come from the southern states and then they migrate to New York. So.
How did you start out making music? I mean, the list of people you played with is like, it seems to me it's endless because I already have a list and then I speak to you and you say like, oh yeah, Lauryn Hill, you know, I work with her there, and then Kool and the gang does that. So it's like it keeps adding and more and more. So how did you start?
I started out in middle school. So I had a choice between band, music, and art, and all my friends were doing music. So I went to music. So it just kind of just happened. I saw the saxophone and I was like, that's it. Let's make it happen.
But you had heard it before?
No, I hadn't heard it before, and then they didn't have any saxophones. So I had to wait for a while, and there was a girl that played the saxophone, and I secretly took hers, and then I used it as my own.
You had to steal a saxophone so you could become a professional.
I mean, I asked her. I said I was not going to give it back. Is it okay? She moved to chorus, and then I stayed the sax. It's embarrassing, but that's how it started.
Well, it's good, though. Did you ever meet her again?
No, I didn't meet her after school. No, that's it. I mean, it was like elementary school, so that was it.
So when did you, you know, become real serious about it? I mean, what did you listen to at that time? What were your influences, maybe?
Well, I'm from Washington Heights, so that's a predominantly Dominican neighborhood. Okay. So I was playing a lot of merengue and salsa. That's how I started. But when I went to high school, it's a performing arts school, LaGuardia in New York. So I was in the jazz band. So my director was Bob Stewart, and he plays with like Brass Fantasy, Sam Rivers, like all the free jazz guys. So he got me into playing, you know, big band music. So right after that, my first gig was like the Duke Ellington Orchestra, the Ghost Band playing in the city.
How old were you then?
Wow, 16, 15, 16. Wow. Something where I was afraid, very afraid. It was pretty young, yeah.
But it's pretty obvious that you, you know, you're not afraid anymore. It's not much that can shock you.
Well, back then, I mean, the first real gig I got with a person, I guess with a name, was I was playing with Clark Terry. He had a band called the Young Titans of Jazz. So that's pretty, that wasn't, that'll train you for anything.
Wow. Yeah, Clark Terry is a legend. I mean.
And he plays fast on the spot. So.
I mean, you go, there's the guy that actually influenced Miles, who is Miles' first idol, and then you're on stage with him and, you know, you're a young upcoming artist. That must be kind of scary.
It was scary. And everybody in the band was older than me, so it was scary. But it helped, it helped.
When did you form the Soul Squad? Because that's, you know, that's your band now.
Yeah, I think I was in college and I had a band called Spirit and we played a lot of jazz music. And then I started, since I was playing with all these R&B people, and I was really, really at the time listening to James Brown and Maceo and Sly and the Family Stone's Fresh album all day. Every day I had Fresh on repeat. And I was like, what if I made a band like this? And Solomon was, he's my best friend. He was actually there and he was like, let's do it. So I like spent all night and wrote some music. And then we just started, and I had to make a MySpace page. And he's like, what are we gonna call it? And I was like, let's call it the Soul Squad. So we just put it together.
Wow.
And that was it.
But then it actually took a little while, you know, for you to actually make Retox.
Yeah, well, because I was also like, I felt like I was, you know, capable of having a band, but I was so busy with my obligations for Sidemen with other artists. Like, when you're playing with other people with names, you have no choice but to
You should name some names. I mean, we're like kind of beating around the bush all the time, kind of. It's like.
I mean, around that time, who was I playing with? I was playing with the Kool & the Gang. I was playing with Stevie Wonder. I was playing, I had done a tour with Prince. I mean, it was a lot of people. I was playing with Rashid Ali. I was playing with Joanne Brackeen. It was a lot of people, a lot of different.
Was it at that time still? I heard a story from a guy who worked with Stevie for a long time who said that you actually needed to know every song in Stevie's book, and he would just count off songs and just play something, and you wouldn't know, you know, sometimes he wouldn't even announce a song out of like the hundreds of songs.
Let me tell you, the first gig, it was I was playing for President Obama's inauguration, and it was
that was your first gig?
Yeah, I was supposed to play with Regina Bell. So I was playing with Regina Bell, and then someone comes over and they go, so does this band want to play with Stevie Wonder? And we're like, yeah, right, all right. So they take us right away in cars to another building. And we play a whole set there, and we're like, see, no Stevie Wonder, it's a free gig. Then he comes out, and he sings a song, and we're like, oh, okay, he's gonna sing a song, and then we go back to normal. he ends up playing for an hour and a half every song in his collection, like just going through them. So if you didn't know them, you were definitely, he's gonna hear, he hears everything. And the last song he played is All I Do. And I know the alto solo on that part. So I was like, I'm gonna start with it and then go. And I started with it and he was like, yeah! So I was like, yes! Like that solo you practice your whole life, I finally got to use it. So I felt good about that. And then we hung out with him after, you know, we took a, so it was fun.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's amazing. I mean, you
it
know.
It was pretty amazing.
What are the things from that you take to your own band? I mean, is there, obviously there's a lot you can learn from the other band leaders you work with.
Everyone has something different. You can see, like, when you play behind somebody, how the audience responds to them, what they like, what they don't like, and you don't have anything to do with it. You can just watch it, and if it didn't go well, you go, oh, that didn't go well. But you can kind of, like, each person, like, Prince is very good at, like, you know, dancing and entertaining and dealing with the music. Stevie is very good at singing and like, it's all music. It's no show. It's all about the hardcore music. You know, everyone has their cool niggas about the dancing. But, you know, you get to see as an entertainer what it is and, you know, try different things out on their shows. And then on your show, you can see how it goes.
It's interesting to me that on Retox, there's so many different people, but it still sounds like, you know, like it's one record. You're making all these different songs, so to speak.
Yeah.
I mean, back in the days, that would have been like, you know, a singles collection or something.
Yeah, it would have been. Well, I was trying to make a soul album. I felt like, you know, it's like from what, 1960 to like, what, the late 80s, early 90s, it's the soul period. And I could, if I picked all the music from the 60s, it would just have one sound. So I was trying to get a soul like collage together, like any possible type of soul would be on this CD. So for that, the, you know, singers, they don't have very versatile voices. You need a different voice for every period.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So that's how I got different people. I was like, this is perfect for this period. This is perfect for this one.
Okay, wow.
Yeah.
I mean, it's amazing. Some of the people on there are like Amp Fiddler.
Yeah.
You know, Crystal Warren, Maya Sukena.
I didn't know Amp before the CD. I played a
so,
show with a...
He just stopped by the studio and said, can I play with
no, I did a show with the David Murray Show in Paris with okay. The Roots. It was a special guest, so the Roots were there. Macy Gray was there. Amp Fiddler was a guest. Tony Allen. And we were all this big, huge band. Brass Fantasy. We're all playing music tribute to Fela and Macy
wow.
Gray. And Amp was on the thing, and I was listening to this, the mixes going back, and he was like, oh, let me hear something. So I let him hear that song with another girl singing it. And he was like, you know, I should be singing this. And I was like, yeah, you should be. And he was playing around singing it. And I was like, yeah, you should. And when I got back home from Paris, it was a La Villette festival. When I got back home, he called me and was like, yeah, so send me the song. And I sent it through the email. And then he sent it back. He recorded it at his house. And was like, here you go. I left the girl on there too. So I was like, okay, thank you. Have a good night. So, that's how
wow.
It happened, yeah.
But pretty much most of the other people are like people you've probably known
most
for a long
of the other
time,
people
China
I've known
Black
for like years. Each a different story, but different bands or different. You know, Crystal and Solomon, they're both from Kansas City. So when I met Solomon, they're like best friends or became one like.
Okay.
I was like, maybe like, it was a long time ago when I met them.
You played in Germany a few times before. You haven't been to Elbjazz before.
Nope.
But you know, you already get in like an impression of
I'm
it,
ready
that, you know you're ready for it. Yeah,
well, like in New York, the shipyards and stuff like that, this is already where they want to put the festivals. They have a Red Hook festival. It's a popular place.
Okay.
It's usually where the rappers go and the hip-hop. It's like the authentic part of the music, they say.
Right,
so you're already
well in this jazz thing. Is authentic, so here we go.
I know it's
and the Soul good. Squad is real authentic, so we're looking forward to that. I put on my dancing shoes.
We're going. Oh, nah. Those are the dancing shoes.
Nah.
Mine are the dancing shoes.
I'll be dancing anyways.
Yeah.
I don't care. Thank you very much, Lakeisha.
Well, thank you. See you at the show.
Absolutely. Dankeschön.